So we'll continue from the last lecture. So we saw two types of losses, that is major loss and minor loss. So major loss is called as friction loss, and we started the derivation for major loss, that is Darcy-Weisbach equation. It is called as Darcy-Weisbach equation. So when in exam it is asked that derive Darcy-Weisbach equation, it is analogous or one and the same to the derivation for major loss due to friction in pipes. Okay. So last time we calculated the forces on the pipe. Okay. So first in this derivation we applied the Bernoulli's equation in section 1 and 2, and we came to a derivation, equation that rho g hf is equal to p1 minus p2. Then we derived out the value of frictional resistance, that is f dash into pl v square. Then now we are going to sum up the forces acting on the pipe. What are the forces? One on cross section 1 1, there is a force p1 into a. On cross section 2 2, section 2 2, there is force p2 into a in negative direction. P1 is in plus x direction while p2 is in minus x direction. Okay, p1 into a is in plus x direction and p2 into a is in minus x direction. Now in which direction the friction resistance will act? As the name suggests, the friction resistance will act always opposite to the flow, right? It is a resistance, right? So it will act in negative x direction. So let's sum up or resolve the forces in the x direction. So resolving all forces in x direction, what we have? P1A, one positive force, minus P2A, it is in left hand direction, that is minus x, and minus f1 is equal to 0. Now we take p1 minus p2 common into a is equal to f1. What is the value of f1? It is f dash pl v square. So we put f dash pl v square instead of f1, and we divide a in the right hand side denominator. We take A in right hand side denominator. So we get finally the equation P1 minus P2 is equal to F dash PLV square upon A. Now, as we have derived, we have equation 1. P1 minus P2 is equal to rho g HF. So this value rho g HF, we put it in the equation what we have up till now derived. So we get rho g HF is equal to F dash PLV square upon A. So HF is equal to F dash PL V square upon A rho G. Okay. This HF we have to calculate, right? This is the energy loss which we have to calculate. Now we'll further simplify. We'll put the value of P and A. What is P? Perimeter. That is pi D or 2 pi R. And A is pi D square by 4. And after solving it, we get 4 by D. We put this 4 by D value instead of P by A. Okay. And also, we put the value for 4 F dash upon rho as equal to F by 2, where F is coefficient of friction or Darcy friction factor. And F dash is what? It is frictional resistance per unit wetted area per unit velocity. Instead of this coefficient F dash, we put the value coefficient F of Darcy friction factor. And now after simplifying, we have equation HF is equal to FL V square upon 2GD. This is the most important equation in pipes. It is the major loss, major energy loss in pipes. Okay. major loss we have learned is due to friction, while minor loss is due to change of velocity in magnitude or direction. So what are the losses due to sudden enlargement, contraction, entrance, exit, obstruction, bend and fittings? Okay, this is a revision, of course. So now we'll see a new concept, that is hydraulic grade line. Okay, so what is a hydraulic grade line? It is defined as the line which gives sum of pressure head. What is pressure head? P by gamma, and datum head Z of a flowing fluid in a pipe. Now this is important with respect to some reference line. So what is in hydraulic gradient line? It is a line plotted. It is a line plotted by using the values of pressure head and datum head. Okay, we'll come back to this definition again. First we'll look this at in a diagram. It will make the definition easier. Okay, so this is the text where it is written datum. This is my reference line. Okay, so now we can see my reference line. So I want to plot a hydraulic grade line. So it is said that it is a sum of datum head. So what is datum head? Datum head is from the height from the datum till center of the pipe. So this is my datum head, correct? This will be my datum head. Okay, this is my datum head Z, and sum of pressure head. What is the pressure head here? Pressure head will be P by gamma. So add P by gamma into Z. So this is my pressure head, that is P by gamma. Okay, so this is a point which I have plotted, right? Can you see the point? Yes. So this is the vertical height P by gamma plus Z, right? This is the vertical height P by gamma plus Z from a reference line. So such points I'll plot over the pipe. Can you see the black points? And after joining these points, I get a hydraulic grade line. Yes, everyone can see the hydraulic grade line. Let's color it with red. Okay, so this is my hydraulic grade line. Okay, so you can see now the hydraulic grade line. I have joined all these points. Okay, so let's come back to the definition of hydraulic grade line. It is sum of pressure head plus datum head plotted with respect to some reference line. That's it. You remember that you have to add the pressure head P by gamma plus the datum head Z, and you have to, you will get some value. Okay, for example, the datum head is 2, Z is 2 and P by gamma is 4. So 4 plus 2 is 6. So I'll plot value 6 with respect to some reference line, and at other point the datum head is 1 and P by gamma is 4. So their sum is 5. Okay, so I'll plot value 5 with reference to datum, and I'll join those two points and I'll get the hydraulic grade line. I hope you are understanding this. Okay. So this is hydraulic grade line. Now let's move to total energy line. So total energy line is sum of hydraulic grade line plus the velocity head. You just need to add the value v square by 2g. You just need to add the value v square by 2g in hydraulic grade line and you will get the total energy line. Let's see in the diagram. Okay. So we have already plotted the hydraulic grade line. These are my points. Now let's add the velocity head. So this is my velocity head. Can you see the small green marker? So that is my velocity head. That is v square by 2g. So maybe my handwriting is not properly visible. So what is the hydraulic grade line now? V square by 2g plus p by gamma plus z. Now we'll plot again the points of hydraulic grade line. This is a total energy line, which whose value is v square by 2g plus p by gamma plus z. So these are my points of total energy line, green points. Okay. So now a very important thing I need to explain here in this topic is there is loss of energy. If there was no loss of energy, imagine the fluid was ideal, there was no loss of energy. What would be the ideal line? This would be the ideal line. One second. This would be the ideal energy line. Can you see? Okay. So this would be constant. The energy would be constant. But now there are losses. Look at the losses. There is loss due to entry, right? Loss due to entry. Here, this much loss has taken place. Okay. Afterwards, at the end, you see this loss, this much loss is due to friction. This much loss is due to friction. Oh my God. This loss is so big, correct? That is why it is called as major loss. And see, the entry loss is small. Here again, there is an exit loss. I'll just show it another color. So this is an exit loss and this is entry loss. Okay, and this is due to friction. So that is why the hydraulic grade line and also the total energy line, they are sloping in manner because there is an energy loss. If there was no energy loss, the hydraulic grade line would have been straight, right? The hydraulic grade line would have been straight like this. Okay. So these two are very important lines within the pipes. Okay. So what did we learn today? Today we learned hydraulic grade line. Just don't get confused by the definition. If you want to find out the value of hydraulic grade, plot the hydraulic grade line, you just sum the pressure head and datum head and take some reference, or they will give some reference in the question only. Take that reference and plot ordinates, the values P by gamma plus Z. And for total energy line, you just plot P by gamma plus Z plus V square by 2G. These are the two important lines in fluid mechanics. Okay, I'll share these slides so that you can go through it once again. And we have learned an important equation, that is Darcy-Weisbach equation for friction loss. That is, the value is FL V square by 2GD. Okay, we'll continue tomorrow. till then you just read these things once again. Okay.